Take a look at your children right now. Are they looking at a tablet, a smartphone, a computer? It could seriously be damaging their eyes.
The number of nearsighted people in the country has nearly doubled from 40 years ago, and children are a big portion of that number. NBC2's Rachel Polansky found out how you can protect your child's eyesight without taking away too much screen time.
This third grader,
when did you get a cell phone?
When I was 7.
Is very comfortable on a smartphone.
What do you do on it?
I play games, watch YouTube, and go on Instagram.
And Elena Wiersma is not in the minority. She tells me that most of the kids in her class have one.
Do you think your kids are using the screens too much?
I totally think that they are.
That's Elena's mom, Heidi. 3 of her 4 kids have smartphones.
It's a lot easier when you're trying to keep them all in check.
She tries to limit their time on their devices.
We've got hockey, soccer, cheerleading, all sorts of stuff, guitar lessons.
They have extracurricular activities.
I'm doing these oranges.
Arts and crafts.
Here's Kelly, Elena.
And at nighttime, she takes away all the phones.
Do you like when mom takes away the phone? Why not?
Because I like it.
Elena might not like it, but her eyes do.
Younger and younger kids are coming with eye strain problems.
Dr. Juan Fernandez sees it all the time. Adults and children who spend a lot of time looking at screens feeling eye fatigue.
Locally, have you seen more children coming in with vision problems related to screen time?
Yes, I'm seeing more kids with problems that are new. They complain of eye strain, they complain of dry eyes, and these are young eyes that shouldn't be having dryness. They shouldn't be having this kind of strain.
Now, you don't have to toss out all of your family's devices. Just follow something called the 20-20-20 rule.
If you're using any kind of screen, every 20 minutes, you should look up at something that's at least 20 feet away for 20 seconds.
Creating technology-free zones can also help.
They're bedrooms. They shouldn't have any screens.
Not only for kids, but also for parents.
Technology and screen is a wonderful thing, but used in moderation.
Yes.
A strategy Heidi hopes will keep her family seeing clearly.
Just have them something else to do. Avert their attention to something else.
Rachel Polansky, NBC.